Mr. Chair, I have an amendment at the desk.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 16, printed in House Report number 114-742, offered by Mr. O'Rourke of Texas.
Pursuant to House Resolution 859, the gentleman from Texas, Mr. O'Rourke, and a member opposed each will control 5 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentleman from Texas.
Mr. Chair, I rise today to speak on behalf of this amendment number 16, which will allow us to help the VA fulfill its responsibilities and truly be accountable to our veterans by hiring enough physicians and care providers so that we can meet the demand and the need and the care that has been earned by these veterans. Today, by the VA's own admission, there are 43,000 authorized, funded, but unfilled positions in our community clinics and hospitals throughout the country. That means that veterans are waiting far too long and in some cases not able to get in to receive that care that they have earned. This amendment would allow the VA to begin doing what everyone else in modern medicine in America is doing today, and that is recruiting effectively from this country's residency programs. Today, the VA is prohibited from talking to residents until they have completely completed their residency. As we all know, by that point, most of those residents have selected an employer, and that employer is not the VA. This brings us into line with every other federal recruiting practice throughout the government and brings us in line with the private and other public sector employers against whom we are competing. I will note that this amendment is also sponsored by Ms. Stefanik from New York. It enjoys bipartisan support, and I urge my colleagues to join me in supporting this. And lastly, Mr. Chair, before I request that I may be able to yield a minute to my ranking member, I want to join him in recognizing the incredible service of our chairman, who has really ensured that this is the most bipartisan committee in the Congress, and that bipartisanship is needed now more than ever if we are going to fix a VA system and deliver the care that those veterans have earned. We're going to need everyone working together as closely as possible, and the chairman has done a lot of work towards that end. And so I want to thank him for his service and for what he's done for this committee and for veterans throughout the country. Mr. Chair, may I inquire as to how much time I have left?
Gentleman has 2.5 minutes.
I would like to yield 2 minutes to the ranking member, Mr. Takano of California.
Gentleman is recognized.
I thank my good friend, the gentleman from Texas, for yielding. Mr. Chairman, I fully support the gentleman's amendment, and I encourage my colleagues to do the same. And I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back.
Mr. Chairman, I yield back.
Gentleman yields back. Gentleman from, for what purposes, gentleman from Florida?
I rise in unanimous consent to seek time in opposition, even though I'm not opposed to the amendment.
Without objection.
I yield myself such time as I might consume.
Gentleman is recognized.
I want to thank Mr. O'Rourke, a valued member of our committee, and Ms. Stefanik for bringing this timely piece of legislation to the floor in amendment form. I think it is very important as the VA tries to recruit new physicians to fill the 40,000+ openings that they may have at any one time. It is important to be able to get the younger folks that are coming in so that they can be a part of the VA system and helping our veterans. With that, I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back. The question is on the amendment offered by the gentleman from Texas. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to. It is now in order to consider amendment number 17, printed in House Report 114-742. For what purpose does the gentleman from Texas seek recognition?
I have an amendment at the desk.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 17, printed in House Report number 114-742, offered by Mr. O'Rourke of Texas.
Pursuant to House Resolution 859, the gentleman from Texas, Mr. O'Rourke, and a member opposed, each will control 5 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentleman from Texas.
Mr. Chairman, as we now know, we are 43,000 providers short within the VA, which means that there is an unmet need and demand from veterans in the communities that we serve and whom we represent. to be able to bridge this gap, we're going to have to more effectively leverage capacity for care in public and private institutions throughout this country. These are public hospitals, public and private clinics. There are different means of doing this right now, which the VA secretary seeks to streamline into one program, and I support this. But in the meantime, while we are largely dependent on the CHOICE program that this Congress passed not too long ago, we must ensure that the care for this veteran, for these veterans, is coordinated in a seamless manner. Part of the problem in doing that is that the medical records for veterans are not effectively traveling with them from the VA to their provider in the community. And in fact, because of an antiquated interpretation of veterans' medical information records, veterans have to sign a waiver allowing the VA to share that information. Now, no other provider of medical care in this country operates under those same standards. And today, it is estimated that fewer than 3% of veterans have affirmatively signed these release forms, allowing their information to be effectively shared with a community provider so that provider can make informed medical decisions for that veteran's treatment. Inclusion of this amendment in the final bill's passage will ensure that we bring the VA up to modern medical standards, where veterans will still be protected by HIPAA and privacy laws, but will have their critical medical information effectively shared without fear of exposure of any of their private and identifiable information. So, Mr. Chairman, I ask that the Congress support this amendment into inclusion in the final bill so that we can effectively leverage that care in the community. And with that, I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back. For what purpose does the gentleman from Florida seek recognition?
To ask unanimous consent to speak in opposition, even though I do not oppose the amendment.
Without objection?
I yield myself as much time as I might consume.
The gentleman is recognized.
Thank you very much. Again, Mr. O'Rourke has brought an outstanding addition to this important piece of legislation. It's critical for continuity and the provision of safe, quality health care to our veterans to allow them to be able to communicate back and forth without any impediments. So I appreciate Mr. O'Rourke's hard work and, again, bringing this amendment to the floor. I urge my colleagues to support it, and I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman yields back. The question is on the amendment from on the amendment offered by the gentleman from Texas. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to. It is now in order to consider amendment number 18, printed in House Report 114-742. For what purpose does the gentleman from Texas seek recognition?
I have an amendment at the desk.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 18, printed in House Report number 114-742, offered by Mr. O'Rourke of Texas.
Pursuant to House Resolution 859, the gentleman from Texas, Mr. O'Rourke, and a member opposed, each will control 5 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentleman from Texas.
Mr. Chairman, I rise today to speak on behalf of this amendment number 18, which we are referring to as the Ask a Veteran amendment to the underlying bill. This essentially builds on some of the pioneering work taking place in the community I have the privilege to represent in El Paso, Texas. Before the wait time scandal broke in Phoenix, we were hearing alarming discrepancies between what the VA was telling us that a veteran was waiting in our community and what we were hearing at our town halls from veterans themselves. So, in order to try to resolve this issue, we conducted a scientific survey by an independent third party with a margin of error under 4% to ask veterans from their own experience and in their own words what they had experienced in terms of care at the VA. We found that instead of meeting the 14-day standard then in place by the VA for access to care, veterans on average were waiting over 70 days to see a primary care physician and over 60 days to see a mental health care provider. Most alarmingly, 37% of the veterans who were surveyed who sought mental health care were not able to get an appointment in 14 days or 60 days or 1 year. They never got in at all. It's important that we remember that in the context of the VHA's recent admission that after a scientific survey of veterans in all 50 states, An average of 20 veterans a day are taking their lives in this country, and 14 of those 20 veterans who will take their lives today have not had a chance to see someone at the VA. We have learned that we cannot depend on the VA to tell us how the VA is doing. We must ask veterans directly. This amendment will do just that. It will, in every community that we serve, ask the veterans themselves how long they are waiting, when they first requested care, and when that was received, the continuity of that care, the quality of that care, and the customer service. If we are to, as the chairman has said over and over again, and which I agree with wholeheartedly, if we are to create a culture of accountability in the VA, we need to ask the veterans directly about their experience. We can no longer make the same mistake of trusting the VA to tell us how the VA is doing. Mr. Chairman, I ask for this body's full support of this measure that will help us hold the VA in check, keep them accountable, and ensure that veterans always have a voice in oversight of this most important institution. Mr. Chairman, with that, I would like to yield 30 seconds to the ranking member, Mr. Takano of California.
The gentleman is recognized.
Mr. Chairman, I thank the gentleman from Texas is yielding 30 seconds for me. Mr. Chairman, I fully support his amendment, and I encourage my colleagues to do the same, and I yield back the balance of my time. The
gentleman yields back.
Mr. Chairman, I yield back.
The gentleman yields back. For what purpose does the gentleman from Florida seek recognition?
To ask unanimous consent to rise in opposition, even though I do not oppose the amendment.
Without objection.
I yield myself such time as I might consume.
Gentleman is recognized.
Again, Mr. O'Rourke has brought another good piece of legislation to the floor. In fact, this has previously passed the House and the 113th Congress. I think that veterans' voices must be heard, and we also must be careful how the questions are asked. We know how any survey or poll can be manipulated. It's very important that this is a trusted survey, so I would urge my colleagues to support this amendment, and I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman yields back. The question is on the amendment offered by the gentleman from Texas. Those in favor say aye. Those opposed say no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to.